There is a linear relationship which exists between the absorbance and molar concentration of a solution. It is commonly known as Beer's law. It describes the relationship between the concentration of a solution in molarity, the path length of the solution being analyzed in centimeters, the molar absorptivity of the chemical in reciprocal molar centimeters, and the absorbance of a chemical solution, which is unitless. As we discuss concentration, remember that molarity equals moles per liter. Molar absorptivity, sometimes referred to as the extinction coefficient, dictates the amount of light that a solution absorbs at a given wavelength. The path length of the chemical solution is based on the length of the cuvette, which is typically 1 centimeter. It should be noted that the absorbance and molar absorptivity of a chemical species are wavelength dependent, meaning they vary depending on which wavelength they are measured at. Most often, Beer's law is applied using the wavelength of maximum absorbance of a chemical species known as lambda max. When more than one species is present in solution, more than one lambda max value will be present, one for each species. Let's take a look at a couple of applications of Beer's law. If you have a red solution of unknown concentration, but you know the molar absorptivity is 2.6 times 10 to the 4th reciprocal molar centimeters, the path length of the cuvette is 1 centimeter, and the measured absorbance of the solution at its lambda max 500 nanometers is 0.750, you can rearrange Beer's law to solve for concentration. Substituting the known values into the equation, the concentration of the solution can be determined. Here we come up with the concentration being 2.88 times 10 to the minus 5 molar. If both the molar absorptivity and concentration of a solution are unknown, you can determine them by creating a standard calibration curve from a set of solutions of known concentration of the same chemical. This is called creating a dilution set. By measuring the absorbance of each of the known concentration solutions, a graph of absorbance versus concentration can be generated. This graph is known as a standard calibration curve. Notice that there is a linear relationship between absorbance and concentration. As the concentration of a solution is increased, the absorbance increases proportionally. Due to this relationship, the trend line equation of the calibration curve, y equals mx plus b, can be related to Beer's law, where y is equal to absorbance, m, the slope of the line, is equal to the molar absorptivity and path length, and x is equal to concentration. The y-intercept B will theoretically be zero since a sample with no dye will give zero absorbance. From the trendline relationship to Beer's law, the molar absorptivity of the solution can be easily determined since the path length B is commonly 1. Once the molar absorptivity of the solution is determined, we can measure the absorbance of the unknown solution and determine its concentration as we showed in our first example. Here, our unknown solution gave an absorbance of 0.392. We know the molar absorptivity is 2.26 times 10 to the 4th, and the path length is 1. What would its concentration be? Did you get 1.73 times 10 to the minus 5 molar when you performed the calculation? Although Beer's law appears to be a very simple equation, it is a very valuable tool for determining many aspects of known and unknown solutions. Other videos in the Chemical Thinking Laboratory related to this video are spectrophotometry and creating a parallel dilution set. Good luck, and thanks for watching.